Nygma versus Gambit.
Oh my dear. Dream. And Sonegon might have to get themselves ready for aggression coming up on Team Nygma. Another Spirit Siphon rolling by the portal smash, and that's a kill. First blood goes to Team Nygma.
There. Oh, he's going into the straight Aghanim Scepter after the face boots. So he's playing the offlane role from the mid lane.
Yeah, they're going in once again on top, and now joining by the Nether Prophet as well. Teleport down behind the tower. Only a few hits away, they're trying to get the gyrocopter, but he's flying, slowly flying away from the danger. He's still being chased by Afterlife. And in Charcrime got him. Let's take a look at the fight around here. Nether Prophet, wow, he's so tanky, man. No one. What is his build? He's hanging in there since 1976, and now finally he goes down, but he brought a lot of space for his teammate. After Light still hanging on as well.
You want to build BKBs too early?
Alright.
It's costed AoE fear from that Aghanim Scepter can really win him teamfights. Warding on bottom
a little
on
bit
the
of...
Enigma.
Yep, Sonego down at the bottom lane. But meanwhile, After Life get it back, and now this is going to get broken too. He locked him down. He was locked down in a Sprout and also the Ice Shard, but he still walk around, but won't be able to crawl back to the base. Die eventually. Nice hunting down by Team ASM Gambit.
Now, I think this game is going to be quite slow until Alchemist gets his first Aghanim Scepter, which is going to go through the Gyrocopter. Rolling in a Miracle again.
Yeah,
he's just dying through the
board. Miracle down.
Miracle is having a rough game. No one getting caught out.
Yeah, rolling boulder in and release Unstable Concoction. He hit him with a Radiance.
Aghanim Scepter up on the Gyrocopter, which is going to be his power spike. And from then on, they want to start controlling the map. Oh, Enigma. Can he just TP?
First time.
Oh, no, cooldown on TP. He should just
activated
be dead.
Exhaust System and also the Spirit Siphon going for Sonego. He surely goes down. Killing spree for Weeha. Maybe it's time for a push the tower a little bit, but hey, let's take a look at this one first. Gambit is looking straight back in the middle lane, locked down in a Sprout. Nice one. Perfect landing by the Native Prophet for Team AS Monaco Gambit.
And they have to make sure that they pressure Gambit a lot.
This might be the first big team fight. They are aiming for the Miracle. Miracle, in my opinion, I think he's quite strong to fight at the middle game right here at 13 minute mark. But however, he needs to be careful about the Timasaur too, but they still want to commit anyway. Here we go, they start the fight with a snowball in, with an uppercut, setting up the Ice Shard. Kuroki moving in and chop one down. The rest of Team ASM Gambit need to walk away. They have to let go. They got one kill on support, it seems to be a good trade.
And I don't know if people saw it, but Black Hole was also cast and cancelled immediately, so they don't have that for a fight. TB TPing in though, they don't want to give up this mid tower for nothing.
Alright.
Oh, Weeha out of position here.
Weeha walking away with such a very fast movement speed. He was slowed down by the Chakram. Afterlight got him. Killing spree. It's still a trade though. Even TB joining the team fight now. Locked down time. The prime target is actually Alchemy stuck in.
Oh, my God, the shards!
Oh, man. Yeah, what an ice shard right there from long, long range from downtown. And that's a double kill for no one.
Yeah. Power in the game is nowhere to be found. Like, he's just so weak right now. Rolling in on Enigma bottom.
Yeah, bottom lane just rolling in. Here we go with the call down. That would be
Rocket
able to kill Sonego. But however, the rest of Team ASM Gambit has teleported down. They're seeking for revenge. Timber Chain, Timber Saw. And I got one kill, man. Kill streak for Afterlife. Man, he's so strong here. Level 13. And now the Timber Chain get back into the fight again. And fighting toe-to-toe against the Gyrocopter. Now he's running away. The race is moving in. Oh man, what a perfect timing. In and out, all the time for Team ASM Gambit. And managed to kill two of Team Nygma.
They will need a very good death from an ulti to do that.
Well, if I'm not wrong, that is actually the first time using the Black Hole. Well, worth it. Got one kill. And at the same time in the lane. Yep, Weeha. They keep die one by one. And now they are pushing on top. It seems like Gambit is not going to give any room for Team Nygma to breathe. They want to take all the objective, like we mentioned during the draft, that they are really focused on pushing lanes. However, Team Nygma knows that they have to fight, they have to protect their towers. They're moving in, but Kuroki drowned real quick.
Stand down, DP.
Because he doesn't have that. Oh my goodness. But however, Miracle stays in the middle and killing everyone. He got one more kill. Weeha also got some kill. He deals a lot of damage with his ultimate. The Exhaust System, next one gonna be After Light. He's trying to keep the chance away, but he's stuck in the middle of Team Nygma player, throwing in Unstable Concoction.
DP going for the BKB. And Kuroki like actually went for Ghost Scepter right away. So he will have no impact in those fights.
That was a very good scouting by G-Edge. He got the Invis rune and he'll get one kill. 5 kill streak ended on no one. Next one gonna be Immersion. He's trying to run away with a snowball. Aichard doing whatever he can.
Which means they're completely back into the game. There's Gyrocopter with Aegis as well as Aghanim Scepter.
Yeah.
He does have a Scotty completed now. Or rather 200 gold. And that's go time for Gambit.
Alright.
Rocket, Malefice, and he's just dead. Safe on top of that.
Yeah,
they do have ways of fighting, of course, with the exorcism. Mm-hmm. A lot of damage. Our man getting caught out of the position here.
Wow, that is fast reaction time by the Ninja Prophet. He turned into BKB after the kill, and I think that's worth it, just to get away safely.
Yeah, what a super.
It feels like if Nygma keep losing one by one like this because of the ward, because of the visions that Team Gambit have, they're just going to slow down that game a lot. And now look at that.
Big smoke up
straight.
Now.
Yeah, into the Golden Triangle, they start the fight with a snowball. Oh, rolling. They see me rolling.
Nice double stun.
They turn on the ASS. Nice double stun though, but will that be enough to kill? ASM taking control of this area, but however, Miracle moving in with a rocket barrage and the flag cannon. And chasing on the water. My goodness, the exorcism throwing in and a stun, unstable concoction, turn to BKB. Seems like a turnaround for Team Nygma. They got 3 kills and it's all important kill for Team Nygma. It's time to just push in, take down mid-tier to tower 2, maybe mid-tier 3.
No, no, they need to make sure nothing gets into the base anymore. Like, that last teamfight was really shaky and Prophet getting caught out again.
Gonna get caught, throwing unstable concoction, instant spray as well. Kuroki stuck over there on a cliff.
He's like, how are you doing down there? Hello. Oh, the swap! TP cancel?
No, he's swapping.
Silence, done.
Teleport, and that's gonna be a kill! Not looking good for Team ASM Gambit. No one got caught.
Shivas got picked up now. Like, DP with Shivas is...
High ground, Miracle get the aim, and here we go with the Walrus Punch, dropping quite low. He's gonna get swapped up in his support, but, well, I wonder if he can just fight on. Yes, he can. Miracle got one kill with the fire cannon. Immersion falls down. He
needs
to run away from the chakra. He was so close. However, this afterlife back to the high ground.
TB damage.
Turn here. He's using U Scepter, trying to buy some time for himself. But once he landed, the TB, T-Blade got him. Miracle toe to toe with T-Blade. Who's going to get it?
Wow.
And it's T-Blade won.
I can't believe that he fought the T-Blade without BKB available, without Satanic available.
Yes, are you ready to rumble? Because on their way back, they're gonna fight each other. They see T-Blade first. But...
Both are smoked up. They're holding the high ground right now. We all know what happens when you hold the high ground. Don't do it.
After lie. Gonna be the first one to go in. Imogen's gonna in Chakram, slow it all down, trying to set up the position for his teammate to just go in. A silencer, the BKB for Viha, still not releasing his exorcism, but he can kill with a Spirit Siphon. TS got them, drop down the magnetize, every single stuff, Dream. T-Blade still holding on to the cheese. And now look at the power of Parablade standing in front of everyone. He is not a glass cannon, definitely, because he's also tanky too. Exorcism deals a lot of damage. Riha with a lot of movement speed moving in.
Sunder
and
Gyro.
He cannot find a target.
Gyro
yes, T-Blade going on that Gyro. Miracle about to go down just a little bit. And now finally, Miracle down with our buyback. T-Blade wants it and lock one more down in a sprawl. He got one more kill for that. It's time for you. Dead Prophet walking back on the higher ground with the spider legs. He's just trying to go on a cliff and maybe try and find some place to teleport. Weha, getting some HP back. Teleport away,
fighting.
That's nothing to stop him, but it's okay. Afterlife, chasing on the Alchemist, trying to walk away, he have HP. And I don't think he can get away from these guys. No one attacking on him. Maybe this is the last unstable concoction he can release before he can stun anyone.
He can release it, and that means no Death Prophet ult. Oh, DP is actually getting caught out of position here. A lot of damage coming through. Sunder is back online again. Be very careful they don't get another turnaround here.
To the bottom lane, it's U-Septon himself.
Oh my god, DP's taking so much damage.
So close. Now 3P down. No buyback as well. It's time for Team ASM Gambit to take down the Frontier 3 tower. Rolling boulder outside, trying to kill the cube there for TX, forcing him away. Throwing the unstable concoction, trying to buy some time for Kuroki. Ace is spray, he already used it, but cannot stop that Keyblade. Dream, Dream in front of him, striking, striking, and striking on that Barrax. About to go down already. That Korean is so big.
Stun.
Okay,
is there a stun? They have to kill him, or is there a stun there?
And he, an uppercut on him. Man, it's so. I mean, it's so painful to see them going in one by one, but they are trying so hard to defend, and they managed to defend the Barrax.
Yeah, but the thing is, if you attack T-Blade and he just sunders you, then you lose.
And yep, they're starting another fight. Let's take a look on this one. After life, slow it down with the Chakram, dropping a call down. Deep hit,
there's no buyback if he dies here. Oh, goes to the TP. Black
Hole. No. Black Hole, that's for you, Kuroki. No buyback for 2
dead
minutes.
For 2 minutes. Time to... So they're going through mid lane. They know there's no Exorcism and they know Alchemist has no buyback. So at least one Rex, maybe even two. Potentially even more because this terrible damage output is ridiculous at this point.
Yeah. Still got a BKB available as well. Now, nice using the swap in order to save the core heroes. But however, he died right away for the support. Iron Man. Hot back right away for Iron Man, but I still kind of...
Damage on the DP,
how are they going to
DP!
Get that T-Blade down and now that... Oh my god, that explosion was so quick. Next one gonna be top tier 2, top tier 3 tower, including the Rax. Miracle staying the nearest to the front line. He's trying to stop it with the Flakanon and also Rocket Barrage. Miracle killing all. Miracle, can he stand all the damage? No one falls. Miracle killing. But Miracle about to go down. Ooh, Team Assault can do damage. Double kill for Miracle. This might be a little bit comeback for Team Nigma. And it's a triple kill for Miracle too. Ooh. They're just gonna take the risk here. They need to win this team fight and end the game immediately. Or they just, I don't think they can stand the Mega Creeps. That's what I'm talking about. This is the most important team fight, guys. D-Blade, Dream. It seems like ASM need to defend with 3 V5 waiting for Nature Prophet and also Timbersaw, the most important heroes, waiting for them. The tower about to go down. Tier 4 tower down. Ice Shard filling up. And Miracle trying to find a perfect spot. Now here we go.
Nice black hole.
On 3, on 4. Rolling boulder in. T-Blade on the BKB. Shooting on the people. Sonego walking away. He already did the black hole. He all did what he could. And now it's Team Nigma to just punch. One more little bit of push. Guys, they're sending in the Great Atrian first. A big,
they're
big
so
tree.
Big actually, wow.
Yeah, very big indeed.
They're humongous.
Alright, start attacking on the tier 4 tower already. Teleported down behind the enemy line and get one kill first.
That's
and then gone, no buyback. Here we go with the black hole. Two stuck in there and grabs it down. Oh my goodness, what a positioning. What a black hole by Team
ASM
Gambit. Another black hole is fall down. It's a JT call from Team Nigma.
And GG. Oh, it was such a tough game. We said once.
Two series and we are in the second game. Able to pick in some situational game.
Yeah, he's a very situational hero. Sometimes can work. Lion getting caught out of position here.
Whoa, right from the start. Right off the bat, it's going to be Sonego. Got Stun. To slow him down. Yeah. Definitely going to be the first blood.
Yeah, they're a cheese team. They pick Huskars and everything.
Yeah, Huskar. They stun. Now,
roll in mid lane. Kick back.
Nice one. Rolling boulder and boulder smash back. It's going to be no one. Oh, to go down, oh man, only one hit left, but Miracle might be him instead.
No,
he's
trouble.
Getting locked down in an eye chart. Strength gain, walking, trying to walk back to the higher ground. Miracle falls.
And this time it pays off a lot. Another roll on the Viper, but missed.
Yeah. Now bottom lane, Batrider is trying to rat on the Drowranger.
He has to be careful here.
Yeah, super scary
he's
lane.
Just dead.
Merchant is also there as well with a snowball in. Keep on slowing and he's running out of the Firefly and then that's it.
And Drow's gonna be level 6 when Batrider comes back to the lane.
Whoa, wait. Yeah.
He doesn't have a ward, be
in.
Careful. Oh, he's a stun blind.
Hit. Strength in. Yes,
so
they
well
can
done.
Gank him down.
And then Miracle just got bullied from there. Like, you need a better block as Morphling.
Okay.
Batrider's behind him. Be careful here.
Earth Spy at the edge of the range. Again, not a great setup by Team Ace Miracle. However, looking to strike back for Team Nygma, spamming a lot of sticky nama. Turn on the Firefly, keep on flying, and died. Sonico, killing spree, double kills already. This might be a triple kill for Sonico. Only a few hits away. It's GS rolling
on the right click. He smoked to dodge the hit. It's only 1k gold deficit now. It used to be 3k.
Good fight for you. ASM, it's up to something. Once again, it's Kuroki. Kuroki moving in. He's level 8. He started to fight with the Gush. And a beautiful rabbit comes out. A combo with a rolling boulder in. Drag it back. That's another kill for Team Nygma. They'll keep it coming. But however, it seems like AS Overlord Gambit knows that they're running out of the big alternate, so they're just gonna go for round 2. Chasing on that Kai Hunter, drop some magnetize, and it's no one standing in
the team fight
to slow everyone down. Morphing moving in as well. Even Dream joining the team fight right here, but Miracle running out of mana, so he can't do that much. He's now stuck in the Earth Spike. Keep on shooting, it's a great 2-for-2. Riha, turn on the Firefly. Can he catch the Viper? Teleport away. But the next target might be Immersion. And he looks a little bit too slow. Maybe because of the sticky armor, he will be caught by Riha. And will surely go down because of that. But Dream moving in and trying to save his teammates. 2v3 right here. Space shot, waveforms in. Afterlife,
Dream
with a black hole. What a play! What a perfect timing by ASM Gambit. Oh man, they keep moving in and out once again. Outplaying Team Nygma. I mean for Team Gambit. And dealing with Morphling at late game is something not funny. Now look at that, somebody teleport down to the post tower. Firefly, Sonego falls, mega kill for Weeha. Looking very good once again for Team Nygma. They gaining control in the mid game. 15 minutes in.
Oh, he's going to the high ground.
Walrus punch. Rabbit comes out on 3 targets. It starts dropping quite low. But the thing is, no one looking pretty healthy, man. He's super tanky. Oh my goodness, Grog is walking away. Viper moving back in and get the kill. Alright, now talking about catching Lion, and they are catching Lion! Dragging it back, Sonico falls down.
Gambit. Like, they're fighting against the Ravage. Hex. Broken. Should be an easy kill on the Tidehunter. And they're also catching the Venture on the other side. So, two very good kills here for Gambit.
Alright. They are now both sides. I had a golden triangle that's jumping in and trying to do the Flaming Lasso. The first one to explode is Immersion quite quick. No one killed Riha real quick as well. Oh yeah, no BKB that you mentioned. Now going in. A Ravage!
Good Ravage!
A beautiful Ravage, yes indeed. Rip on enter on the BKB for Morphling. And that's a double kill for Miracle. Whoa, this might be the combatant you were saying about that. He can rolling boulder to strike from behind. Smoke it all up. Riha moving in quite fast with 488 movement speed, and now he finds somebody frame break first to the higher ground. Oh, look at Riha taking a lot of damage from the Ground Ranger. He got the speed heavy and he's shooting from the cliff, and that's what I'm talking about. It's a black hole for Morphling.
I can't believe that happened. Ground Ranger lineups push incredibly fast.
We started by Team Nygma's side. This is quite dangerous.
Yeah, this is the game deciding fight here.
Yeah, waveforms in, they're trying to find Lion, but very fast reaction by Lion, hex him first. That actually slowed down the chase of Team Nygma a lot. Now look at the fight, we are getting to the mid
black
fight,
hole
the
three.
Black hole on three! Oh my goodness, what a black hole! It bowed down for Team Nygma, and it's a chance to score up to the high ground.
He didn't BKB on time on Morphling, like he waveformed it, but he didn't BKB, so he got hexed, he couldn't kill the Lion right away.
Oh, GH rolling in. Yep. DS about to go down as well.
Good Ravage
shot from the lower ground, but however, the Ravage seems to be very beautiful, which is not unable to stop him. AS Monaco Gambit to killing all his teammates. Kuroki tried his best. We are on monster kill streak, still fighting targets, search and destroy. And another down.
Morphling is just all the damage they have. It's a 4 protect 1 lineup. If your 1 is dead, can't take the fight. And they're probably just gonna look to take the tier 4 towers here.
Yeah.
Morphling has to be really careful. Like, this Draw Ranger can kill him in seconds.
3 versus 4. Attacking the throne already. No Rabbit, but Croak is still coming in, as well as Morphling on the BKB. He's trying to fight toe to toe, but can he stand the damage? No, I'm in the first one who falls. Morphling, the only one left, waveform away. Ice Charge is the only thing between him and the damage dealer. And it's a GG call.